In this screencast, we will look at transient conduction with an iron sphere diameter 20 centimeters at initial temperature of 30 degrees C. It's suddenly placed, and the fact that it says suddenly means that this is going to be transient conduction in a bath at T equals 300 degrees C. Our initial temperature is 30 degrees C, and our bulk temperature is 300 degrees C. Using the following information, the density, the heat capacity, the thermal diffusivity, the heat transfer coefficient, and the thermal conductivity, we need to find the center temperature of the sphere after 200 seconds. So our time is going to be 200 seconds. The easiest way to solve a transient conduction problem is to use lumped capacitance. But in order to do that, you have to have a Biot number of less than 0.1. So let's go ahead and calculate this number. The Biot number is the heat transfer coefficient, which is 1,000 watts per meter squared K, times a characteristic length, which for this situation is the radius, 0.1 meters, divided by 3, and all divided by our thermal conductivity, which is 80.2 watts per meter K. And when we calculate this, we find that this is 0.4, which is certainly greater than 0.1. So we will not be able to use lumped capacitance. Instead, what we will use is an exact solution that was determined. And what we will try to do is use the one-term approximation of this exact solution. And in order for us to be able to do that, we have to calculate the Fourier number, which is a dimensionless time, and it has to be greater than 0.2. So the first thing is, let's look at this governing equation. So our dimensionless centerline temperature, which is equal to T0 minus T infinity divided by the initial temperature minus T infinity, this is equal to a constant times the exponential of a minus. Now, this is one of the transcendental roots of the exact solution, squared times the Fourier number. So in order to solve for that, we have to look up and tabulated data what our C1 and our root 1 are. And these are both a function of this Biot number, but it is not the Biot number that we just calculated. Here, the Biot is equal to our H times our radius of the sphere divided by K. And when we calculate that out, we get a Biot number of 1.2. And then looking up in the tabulated data, we are able to find our C1, which is 1.5485, and then our other constant, which is 1.9308. Now, let's calculate our Fourier number. So as I mentioned before, this Fourier number is thought of as a dimensionless time, and it's alpha, which is the thermal diffusivity, times time divided by our radius squared. This thermal diffusivity is actually our thermal conductivity divided by the density divided by the heat capacity. So as we are given our thermal diffusivity, that's 23.1 times 10 to the 6th meters squared per second, and our time is 200 seconds, and we divide this all by 0.1 meters squared. And when we calculate our Fourier number, we find that it's 0.462, which is greater than 0.2, which means that we can go ahead and use that one-term approximation. So our T0 minus T infinity divided by our initial temperature minus T infinity equals 1.5485 exponential of negative 1.9308 squared times 0.462. And when we calculate that out, this equals 0.277. So let's go ahead now and solve for this T0. That's 0.277 times Ti minus T infinity, which is minus 270 degrees Celsius, plus 300 degrees Celsius, which is our T infinity. And we find that after 200 seconds, our centerline temperature or center of the sphere is 225.3 degrees C. Now, let's say instead we had used our lump capacitance. Then our temperature would have been negative 270 degrees C times our exponential of minus H times A sub S, which is the surface area, divided by the density times the volume times the heat capacity, all multiplied by T, and this entire expression is added to our T infinity. So here, our temperature is going to equal minus 270 degrees C times 0.18 plus 300, which equals 251 degrees C. So you can see there is quite a difference between the two methods. The one thing that you have to remember, though, is using the lumped capacitance assumes that there is no spatial differences within the solid at any given time. So once we look for our center temperature, which we originally did, it's going to be a lot different from the surface temperature using the exact solution, but it should be exactly the same throughout the solid if we were using lumped capacitance.